In the last session, we have seen how to use the method called last in XPath to identify the last element on your selection. Okay. So now we'll understand the next method called as contents. What is this contents? So if you guys are familiar with Java or familiar with Python, right? So contents is the method which is going to help the user to search any given word is available in the source string or not. So it means that I have a string and I want to search some word in that particular string. I don't know where exactly the position is, but I'm sure that it might be available in the starting, or it might be available in the ending, or it might be available in the middle of the given source string. I don't know exact position of that, but I'm sure my given word is available somewhere in the given source string. Now I want to go and identify it. Okay, there in Java, right, what you are going to do, we are going to use your string variable dot contents of some word, and we are going to get a Boolean value. Similarly, in this XPath also, right, you have an attribute, but you don't know where exactly the constant word is going to be available. Okay, so the rest of the words are getting changed dynamically in runtime. In such cases, right, we can able to use your contents. Okay, so when you want to use this one, when the attribute value is getting changed and only some part of the attribute remain constant. Okay, so whenever the sum, only some part of the attribute value is going to be remain same or constant, in such cases, right, we use contents method, guys. We use your contents method. So what is the syntax for this? The syntax for this is same like HTML tag, right, square brackets, contents, parentheses and square brackets again, at the rate of attribute comma single quotes value. So this is the syntax that we need to be followed by using your contents. So let's take an example where I can able to go and implement this contents method very easily. Say suppose the first go, I have my ID as, so I have a 123 QA, some like 678. And the second go, what happened here is, I'm getting my QA 9807. The third go, I'm going to get my ID as 34A QA like this. So now what happened here is, the numerics are getting changed. And if I remain constant, the word is going to be QA. If something is going to remain constant here in this particular attribute, QA is going to be remain same. But I cannot determine where exactly QA is going to be, either in the starting position or in the ending position. As I'm not sure that where the data is going to be remain constant, right? I cannot take a decision that, I cannot fix a position for that. So in such cases, what I'm going to do, right? I'm going to use my contents of QA. I'm going to take the help of the QA as a constant word, and I'm going to implement my contents method. So now my tag should be look like, suppose this is going to be input tag, input, square brackets, contents. So first try to compute your syntax and then go and implement your logic. So at the rate of ID, comma, QA. So now this is going to give you one or more elements. Why? If there are any other elements are getting matched with this QA, right? Who is having the ID with the QA will be get identified. So that is the reason you may get one or more elements. Okay. Yesterday I told you, like, when you are going to get one or more elements, how to get a unique element out of that is very simple, just by grouping it. Grouping is going to be represented as parentheses. Just group it and then try to give your indexing number. This is the way how you want to do. So now let's go and check out an example on the web application and see like how these contents will be applied on the any type of browser, be it Chrome browser or Firefox browser. So let me go and open my Chrome browser and we'll navigate to an application and check out how that is going to be help us. Now, let me take an example of the same thing. I'll inspect this. So assume that I want to identify the elements whose ID is having as name. I want to identify the elements. I'm not telling identify the element, elements whose ID is going to be having the attribute value as name. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'll go and inspect my first name. Assume that this first is going to be replaced every time with some other value, but name is going to be always constant. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do, right? Control F, double forward slash. What is the HTML tag? Input is going to be my HTML tag, square brackets. What I told you, go and compute your syntax first. Then at the rate of ID, comma, single quotes as name. Now see, I'll be getting two different elements because if I go and see my first name for the ID, I have first name as an ID where I have a name as a value again. Again, if I go and see here, there is a last name. Again, we have a attribute value as name. So it means that, right, contents is going to help me, right, to get one or more elements. Okay. At the same time, if the attribute is getting changing its value, only some part of the attribute value is going to remain constant. In such cases, right, I'm going to use my contents method.